Cheshire and a Jack Russell Terrier. Traditionally, two docking dudes perform on breeds like Mini Pinscher and Jack Russell in order to qualify for dog shows. This is a Be Kind Pets veterinary educational video sponsored by Toa Payoh Vets, a video to educate veterinary students and pet owners about the common methods of tail docking or tail amputation. What is tail docking? It is an intentional removal of part of an animal's tail. The main difference between tail docking and tail amputation is when tail docking is usually performed on younger puppies aged between 2 to 3 days old, while tail amputation is more on older puppies and injured dogs. There are 4 main methods for tail docking or tail amputation. First, bending. Second, perpendicular cut. Third, 45 degrees cut. And lastly, V incision. A rubber band is placed tightly over a puppy's tail. This effectively cuts off the blood supply to the end of the tail. The gangrenous end of the tail drops off as it has no blood supply. Tie the tail with a rubber band. A puppy's tail is cut at 90 degrees to the length of the tail. The tailbone is exposed and there will be no hair at the exposed end. Step 1. Place the scissors vertical to the tail. After the cut, the tailbone is exposed and it is not possible to be covered without an excessive scar. V incision. A mark will be drawn across the tail as a guideline for the cut. Once cut, the upper end will be longer than the lower end, which is able to cover the tailbone that is exposed. The top two new V will later on be stitched. It is a tail amputation method. Step 1. Mark the area of the incision as a guideline for the cut with a marker. Step 2. Cut according to the markings. The upper end of the tail usually end up longer than the lower end, which is able to cover the exposed tailbone. Lastly, stitch the excess skin together. Place the scissors at 45 degrees on the rear of the tail, pushing back the skin towards the anal, followed by a cut. The skin that have been pushed back will retract back to its original position, covering the tailbone. Step 1. Place the scissors at 45 degrees on the rear of the tail. Step 2. Tilt the scissors. Step 3. Push the skin towards the anal area with the scissors. Lastly, the excess skin that have been pushed back retracts back to cover the exposed tailbone. Tail docking using the 45 degrees cut is shown in this video. Warning, this video contains surgical procedures, viewer's discretion. Angle the scissors at 45 degrees, tilt the scissors, push the skin towards the inner area and cut. After the cut, put some potassium permanganate powder onto the open wound to stop the bleeding. The powder aids in healing the wound. Have a quick and thorough check before handing over to the owner. Make sure that the puppies are not bleeding. Of tail docking. A Rottweiler was brought in for an unsuccessful tail docking by its owner. A deep strangulated wound was the result of the tightly tight band on its tail for 5 days. There are bacterial infections in its wound. The vet advised tail amputation for the puppy, and it was placed under observation for 1 to 2 days.